So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and in today's session guys, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question, which says, out of the following, select the correct statements regarding Manas app. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding this app, which is known as Manas. And this app, guys, has been launched by the principal office of the principal scientific advisor to the government of India. Alright, so let's discuss about this app. So as I told you, the office of the principal scientific advisor to the government of India has launched a mobile app which is known as Manas. And Manas has a full form also, Mental Health and Normalcy Augmentation System. Mental Health and Normalcy Augmentation System. You should remember the full form. It is the full form. And this app, guys, has been launched to promote mental well-being across all the age groups. हमारे जितने भी age groups हैं उसके across mental well-being को promote करने के लिए this app has been launched. And by the way, who is the principal scientific advisor? It's Professor K. Vijay Raghavan. K. Vijay Raghavan is the principal scientific advisor to the government of India. All right. And guys, the motto of this app is Uttam Man Saksham Jan. Uttam Man Saksham Jan. Remember the motto. And it was initiated by the office of the principal scientific advisor. And it will be executed by AFMC, Armed Force Medical College, NIMHANS and CDAC, Center for Development of Advanced Computing. So, in three organizations ka naam aapko yaad rakhna hai. Initiate kisne kiya hai? Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India. And it will be executed by AFMC, CDAC and NIMHANS. Alright. And what are the key features of the app? So, guys, it is based on the life skills and core psychological processes. It will be universally accessible. It will deliver age-appropriate methods depending on the age group of the user. And it will also promote positive attitude, which will be focused on mental well-being. Now we are discussing, guys, about the key features, about the benefits, about the uses of a particular portal, about a particular app, because we all know that the exam is now 50% descriptive. So we have to focus on the descriptive part also. So descriptive mein aap in cheezo ka istamal kar sakte hain. Now what are the uses? So guys, the application can be used for a person's overall well-being, and it will be supported with teleconsultation for mental health related problems. So a person can use the teleconsultation provision given in the app, and uske through jo person hai wo kisi doctor se consult kar sakta hai. A person can consult a doctor for his or her mental health well-being. There will be health tracking and all data records that will be maintained in the app, and it will help users also during the future consultations. All right, and of course, this type of intervention, guys, can help policy developers, policy makers in understanding the mental health of the users. जिससे कि जो हमारे जो भी users होंगे इस app के उनके mental health के बारे में policy makers को पता चल पाएगा, and then accordingly they can design or implement a policy or a program for the mental well-being of our country. Alright. So this was, guys, about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statements regarding Manas app. It is launched by the principal scientific advisor to the government of India. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Manas stands for Mental Health and Normalcy Advisory System. So that's not advisory, that's augmentation. This A stands for augmentation, which means this statement is incorrect. The initial version will be focused on the age group 15 to 40. No, that is incorrect. Isme age group ka koi define nahi kiya gaya hai. It is for all the age groups. And it is jointly executed by AFMC, NIMHANS and CDAC. This is absolutely correct, which means we have first and fourth statement which are correct. So therefore, option A, 1 and 4 will be the correct answer. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which says, the United Nations Secretary General has called for the first ever United Nations Food System Summit to be held in September 2021 in India itself. Ye kahan pe hoga? India mein hoga. Which of the following is not one of the correct action tracks the summit will focus on? इनमें से कौन से action track के ऊपर summit focus नहीं करेगा? So let me tell you, there are 5 action tracks the summit will focus on. So let's discuss about this. So it is in news. It was why we are discussing about UN Food System Summit 2021, because recently India holds National Dialogue on United Nations Food System Summit 2021 that is going to be held in September 2021 in India, and it was held to for a consultative process which culminate in the Food System Summit in September 2021, in which our Prime Minister is likely to participate. All right. Now, what is the meaning of food system, guys? Food system ka matlab kya hota hai? It refers to the group of activities involved in producing, processing, transporting and consumption of food. मतलब food से related कोई भी चीज, कोई भी अगर process है, उस पूरे system को मिला के हम क्या बोलते हैं? Food system बोलते हैं. It is a group of activities involved in the producing, processing, transporting and consumption of food. All right. And talking about the Food Systems Summit, the United Nations Secretary General has called for the first ever United Nations Food System Summit to be held in September 2021. It seeks to strategize the actions for positive change in the agri-food systems in the world. हमारी पूरी दुनिया का जो agri-food system है, उसके अंदर positive change लाने के लिए, actions को strategize करने के लिए, इसका basic objective होगा. And guys, it will also focus on pathways to shape the food systems nationally and globally to accelerate the progress in the sustainable development goals. जो हमारे sustainable development goals है, जो हमें achieve करना है by the year 2030, उसको accelerate करने के लिए nationally और globally pathways develop किए जाएंगे for the food systems. Alright. And the system guys will focus on 5 action tracks. Number 1 is the safe and nutritious food. Number 2, sustainable consumption patterns. Number 3, nature positive production. Then we have advanced equitable livelihoods. Then number 5, it's resilience to vulnerabilities, stress and shocks. All right. So these are the 5 action tracks the summit will focus on. Okay. And talking about India at the Food System Summit 2021. So guys, we all know India mein around 18% of the world population hai. India owes 18% population of the total population of the world. And India has volunteered to Action Track 4, which is Advanced Equitable Livelihood. And iske liye Government of India ne committee banayi hai. Government of India has also constituted a committee under the chairpersonship of Mr. Ramesh Chand. And the duty of this committee will be to hold national dialogues with all the stakeholders of agriculture and food systems to explore national pathways in creating sustainable food systems in the country. Hamare desh mein sustainable food system create karne ke liye ये जो कमेटी है ये क्या करेगी, जितने भी स्टेक होल्डर्स हैं ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चर एंड फूड, उनसे बात करेगी, उनसे कंसल्ट करेगी, एंड देन अ पाथवे विल बी डेवलप फॉर द सस्टेनेबल फूड सिस्टम ऑफ आवर कंट्री. ऑलराइट, सो दिस वाज गाइस अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. द यूनाइटेड नेशन सेक्रेटरी जनरल हैज कॉल्ड फॉर द फर्स्ट एवर यूनाइटेड नेशन फूड सिस्टम समिट टू बी हेल्ड इन सेप्टेंबर 2021. एंड रिमेंबर गाइज, It will not held in India. अभी इसका venue decided नहीं है. I'm sorry, I beg your pardon. India में national dialogue हुआ था इसके लिए. I beg your pardon. अगर आपने note में लिख लिया है कि it will be held in India, so please make a correction. ऐसा नहीं है. अभी इसका venue decide नहीं हुआ है. अभी इसका एक national dialogue था जो कि India में हुआ था. Okay. Question is, which of the following is not one of the correct action tracks the summit will focus on? Safe and nutritious food है. Food for all. Food for all नहीं है, so option B will be the correct answer. Let's read out the other options also. Nature positive production, it is there. Advanced equitable livelihoods is there. Resilience to vulnerabilities, shock and stress is there. So option B here is the correct answer. And remember, let me repeat this. September 2021 में होगा, venue decided नहीं है. India में होगा या नहीं होगा, इसके बारे में भी कोई confirmation नहीं है. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Which of the following is not correct about the National Startup Advisory Council? National Startup Advisory Council ke regarding, you have to identify the incorrect statement or statements. Now, why we are discussing about National Startup Advisory Council? Because recently, the very first meeting of the National Startup Advisory Council was held. Sabse pehli meeting National Startup Advisory Council ki abhi hui hai, under the chairpersonship of the Minister of Commerce and Industry. And who is that? It's Mr. Piyush Goyal. Piyush Goyal is the Minister for Commerce and Industry, and we all know he is the Minister of Railways also. Railway Minister bhi yahi hai. And the National Startup Advisory Council, guys, the ex officio chairperson is the Minister for Commerce and Industry. You should also remember this. Now, this meeting, guys, was held to drive sustainable economic growth and generate large scale employment opportunity in the area of innovation and startups. Now, talking about NSAC, so it was constituted by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, DPIIT, and its role is to advise the government on the measures needed to build a strong ecosystem of innovation and startup in our country. हमारे देश में इनोवेशन और स्टार्टअप जो इकोसिस्टम है उसके रिगार्डिंग एडवाइस करने के लिए टू द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया दिस एनएसएसी नेशनल स्टार्टअप एडवाइजरी काउंसिल वाज कंस्टिट्यूटेड बाय डीपीआईआईटी एंड दीज आर सम ब्रॉड फंक्शंस इट विल सजेस्ट मेजर्स टू फॉस्टर अ कल्चर ऑफ इनोवेशन अमंगस्ट द सिटीजंस एंड स्टूडेंट्स इट विल प्रमोट इनोवेशन इन ऑल द सेक्टर्स ऑफ द इकोनॉमी अक्रॉस द कंट्री एंड इट विल सपोर्ट क्रिएटिव एंड इनोवेटिव आइडियाज थ्रू इंक्यूबेशन एंड रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट to transform them into the valuable products. All right, so these are some basic functions or you can say the broad functions of NSSE. You should remember all these functions. Ye functions aapko yaad rakhne chahiye because you never know ki NSSE pe hi koi question aa jaye exam mein. Now talking about the structure, so as I told you, it is chaired by the Minister for Commerce and Industry and there are two types of members in it. Number one is the ex officio and then we have non-official. Ex officio mein the nominees of the concerned ministries or the departments not below the rank of joint secretary to the government of India. Non-official mein bhi nominate kiye jayenge from the various stakeholders such as founders of successful startups, veterans who have grown and scaled companies in India, persons who are capable of representing interest of investors into startups, etc. So basically, इनोवेशन और स्टार्टअप से रिलेटेड जो भी स्टेक होल्डर्स हैं उन सभी में से नॉमिनेट किया जाएगा नॉन ऑफिशियल मेंबर्स. ऑलराइट, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन. नेशनल स्टार्टअप एडवाइजरी काउंसिल के बारे में इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट बताना है. इट इज कंस्टिट्यूटेड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्री एंड इंटरनल ट्रेड. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. इट इज चेयर्ड बाय द मिनिस्टर फॉर कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. यस. नॉमिनीज बिलो द जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी लेवल रैंक टू द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया विल बी द एक्स ऑफिशियल मेंबर्स. नो, not below the joint secretary level. So this statement is incorrect. Founders of successful startups will be the non-official member of the council. Yes, this is absolutely correct. So only one statement is incorrect here. That is only three. Option B, only three will be the correct answer. And now guys, let's move ahead to question number four. The Ministry of Electronics and IT, which is headed by Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, his Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib. His Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib and he is also the law minister of our country. Kanun Mantri bhi hai ye. So this ministry has inaugurated some new initiatives of National Internet Exchange of India, which in short is NICSI, to facilitate adoption of IPv6. Now what is this IPv6? IP means Internet Protocol version 6, and create an environment to ensure smooth transition from IPv4 to IPv6. So we are transiting from IPv4 to IPv6. And for its smooth transitioning, some of the initiatives of NICSI has been launched by the Ministry of Electronics and IT. Which is are not included in the list? Which of the following is are not the initiatives that have been launched by the Ministry of Electronics and IT? So guys, these are the three initiatives. Number one is IP Guru, then we have NICSI Academy, and then we have NICSI IP Index. And they have been launched to facilitate the adoption of IPv6 and create an environment to ensure smooth transition from IPv4 to IPv6. Now, a question aapke dimaag mein aa raha hoga, you must be wondering why directly from IPv4 to IPv6? Where is IPv5? IPv5 kahan gaya? So guys, IPv5 ke baare mein kuch clear information nahi hai, but yes, most of the people are saying that IPv5 was developed for the experimental purpose only. IPv5 developed hua tha, but for the experimental purpose, it was not used on the large scale. It is the best accepted theory regarding the IPv5. Iske baare mein kuch clear information nahi hai. But yes, the best accepted theory is that it was developed for the experimental purpose and it was used by the big players like Apple and Microsoft. Right? So IPv5, so ab hum IPv4 se direct kahan pe ja rahe hai? IPv6 pe. Now talking about IPv4, it was the first major and most widely used version of internet protocol. It is used to identify devices on a network using an addressing system. जो आपका हमारा IP address होता है, IP address को verify किया जा सकता है through this IPv4, and it provides an addressing capability of approximately 4.3 billion addresses. Now talking about IPv6, so it is the most recent version as I told you, and it is also known as IPNG. What is IPNG? Internet Protocol Next Generation, and it has the capability to provide an infinite number of addresses. Why? I'm saying infinite number because this number is 2 raised to the power 128. So that is why some people are saying it has the potential to provide an infinite number of addresses. All right. Now, what are the benefits of transitioning to IPv6? So it can easily accommodate the growing number of networks worldwide, and it will also help in solving the IP address exhaustion problem. Basically, क्या होता है, जो हमारा IPv4 है उसकी एक लिमिटेड पोटेंशियल है ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग यू नो, जो उसकी एड्रेसिंग कैपेबिलिटी है वो एक लिमिटेड है, राइट? बट जो IPv6 है, क्योंकि उसकी एड्रेसिंग कैपेबिलिटी इनफाइनाइट है, सो जो हमारा एग्जॉशन प्रॉब्लम हो जाता था, खत्म हो जाता था, आईपी एड्रेस की जो सर्चिंग थी वो खत्म हो जाएगी. इट अलाउज सिंपल, सीमलेस एंड कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव कनेक्टिविटी फॉर सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स, एंटरप्राइजेस एंड एंड यूजर्स. इट इज कंसिडर्ड स्पेशली इंपॉर्टेंट विद द इम्पेंडिंग मूव टू 5G, एंड इट हैज अ प्राइवेसी प्रोटोकॉल ऑल्सो टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड यूजर प्राइवेसी. ऑलराइट, now these are the three initiatives. Number one is IPv6 expert panel, which is also known as IP guru. It is a group to extend support to all the Indian entities who are finding it technically difficult to migrate from IPv4 to IPv6. jin logo ko, jin companies ko IPv4 se IPv6 jaane mein challenge face ho raha hai, unko ye technical support provide karaya jayega through this group, which is known as IP guru, and it is a joint effort of the Department of Telecom under the Ministry of Electronics and IT and the industry. Nixi Academy is created to educate technical and non-technical people in India to learn and relearn technologies like IPv6. IPv6 के बारे में जानकारी देने के लिए, educate करने के लिए, this Nixi Academy has been launched. And talking more about the third initiative, which is Nixi IP Index. So Nixi has developed an IPv6 index portal for the internet community, which will showcase the IPv6 adoption rate in India and across the world. IPv6 का adoption rate क्या है हमारे देश में और पूरी दुनिया में, Nixi IP index के through हम देख पाएंगे. Alright. So I hope guys this news is clear, and now let's come back to the question, which is are not included in the list. Not included. So IP Guru is there, Nixi Academy is there, Nixi IP index is there, IP Gyan and Nixi Talent are not there. So which means option C, 4 and 5 will be the correct answer. All right, I hope guys this question is clear, and now let's come to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Dash is envisioned as a competition among cities to recognize their efforts in adopting and scaling up various initiatives under Eat Right India, which is being implemented by FSSAI. FSSAI implement kar raha hai Eat Right India ko. Now this brings me to a question: who is the CEO of FSSAI? Write down in the comments, who is the CEO of FSSAI? So let's talk about this news. So Eat Smart Cities Challenge and Transport for All Challenge, these two challenges have been launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. He is also the Minister for Civil Aviation. And these two challenges guys have been launched to create an environment of right food practices and habits. This is the objective of Eat Smart Cities Challenge. And what is the objective of Transport for All Challenge? It is to make public transport safe, affordable, comfortable and reliable. All right. Talking about the Eat Smart Cities Challenge, so it is envisioned as a competition among cities. Jo cities hongi, unke beech mein competition hoga. For what? To recognize their efforts in adopting and scaling up various initiatives under the Eat Right India movement, which is being implemented by FSSAI. The challenge is open to all the smart cities, capital cities of states and UTs, and cities with a population of more than 5 lakh. So, ye sari cities compete karengi aapas mein to recognize their efforts in adopting the various initiatives under the Eat Right India movement. And talking about the Transport for All Challenge, so this initiative guys has been launched in collaboration with the Institute for Transportation and Development Policy, and it aims to bring together cities, citizen groups and startups to develop solutions that will improve the public transportation system of our country. All right. So I hope guys this news is also clear. Dash is envisioned as a competition among cities to recognize their efforts in adopting and scaling up various initiatives under Eat Right India. So it's Eat Smart Cities Challenge. Option E here is the correct answer. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Aapko ye session kaise laga? Comment karke zarur bataye. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.